Why on earth would anyone want a smart shower, and what benefits could it possibly give you? Well, this is a smart home channel, so I guess it's my job to try and defend that. Today, I'm going to show you the Mira Activate Digital Shower. You can get this shower in a variety of configurations, including ceiling fed with a dual or single outlet, or wall fed also with a dual or single outlet. All of those are available in either a pumped version suitable for low pressure tank systems or non-pumped versions suitable for mains pressure water if you have a heat pump, combi boiler or any other sort of unvented system. Forgetting about any smart features for a minute, the brilliant thing about digital showers like these is the level of temperature and pressure control you get. You can set an exact water temperature and the controller will take care of mixing the water for you. If you have the pumped version, then it'll boost the pressure if you want it to, and the non-pumped version can restrict the pressure. I want to be clear that this is not a sponsored video. I chose this product myself after doing a bit of research and I liked it so much I purchased two of them. I originally had the pumped dual outlet version when we had a tank fed gravity water system, and then when we had our heating system updated I went out and got the single outlet high pressure version to replace it. So as you saw in the introduction, this shower has a warm up function. This starts the shower and runs it until the water has reached the temperature that you've set on the dial. You just twist that dial to adjust the temperature to what you want, by the way, it's that easy. Anyway, once the shower is up to temperature, the shower pauses so it doesn't waste water. You can then get into the shower and resume it. It's a really handy feature. So on its own, without any smart features at all, this is an excellent shower. The smart features are therefore an added bonus for that extra geeky cherry on the top. Now, there's an app that goes with the shower and the shower connects to it using Bluetooth. In the app, you can control your shower, turning it on or off, or set the flow rate and temperature. You can also configure presets, which are combinations of your preferred temperature, flow rates, plus a time limit. And if you have the dual outlet version, you can also set which outlets are used. Now remember these presets for later, when I go over how you can control this shower in Home Assistant. These presets are very important for that. What I also find really great about the app is the information it gives you on your water usage, and it collects that over time. And you can also get the duration of your most recent shower, so you can prove whether your kids were having ridiculously long showers or not. Now, to get that water usage dashboard, you do need to enable the smart functionality of the shower and connect it to your Wi-Fi network. The process is straightforward, you just follow the on-screen instructions. I won't go through that here, but once you have that set up, you can then go through a second process to connect the shower to Amazon Alexa or Google Assistant. So let's dive into how we control this shower from Home Assistant then. Now, step one is to connect your shower to Wi-Fi and also connect it to Amazon Alexa, because the way I have this working is a real bodge that relies on that link. You will also need to make sure you have Home Assistant connected to Alexa, either using the paid-for Naboo Casa subscription or using the more complicated manual Alexa integration method, which I'll put a link to down in the description for you. This process starts in Home Assistant, where you need to create a button helper. When you press this button, it will trigger an automation. The automation will turn on another helper, but this time it's a toggle helper, also known as an input boolean. Now you need to share that toggle helper with Alexa, so as it detects it as an other type of device. When the status of the Home Assistant toggle turns on or off, then the status of that shared device in Alexa also changes. In the Alexa app, you then have to create a routine that triggers when that shared toggle helper opens, which is the terminology Alexa uses for the toggle helper because it thinks it is a door contact sensor. That routine will turn on one of your shower's scenes, which is how your shower's presets appear in Alexa. When the scene is turned on, Alexa sends a command to your shower to start that preset, and if all goes well, your shower will turn on. There is one quite critical part of this solution I haven't mentioned yet, and you may already be thinking, but what if you turn the shower on and the shower door is wide open? Won't it just flood the bathroom? Well, yes it will, unless you add a door contact sensor to the shower door. I've used an Aqara door and window sensor because it's tiny and I'm told it doesn't mind the humidity. It is Zigbee though, so you need a Zigbee hub connected to Home Assistant for it to work, and I've also placed it as high up as possible on the shower door to keep it away from water as much as I can. So let's dive into Home Assistant then and see what this looks like there. These are my two helpers. You can see that the first one is a toggle helper, which is the entity that you have to share with Alexa. The second second one is the button which you press to turn the shower on or off. Now you can control that button either on your Home Assistant dashboard, or you can have a button press as an action for another automation that might be linked to a physical smart button, for example. If I show you the settings of the button, you can see that I gave it a nice shower icon too. Now for the automation, the trigger is the button press of course, and we need to make sure that we add a condition to check that the door is closed based on the status of the contact sensor. For the actions, we turn on the toggle helper, which will of course toggle the shared sensor in Alexa too. But because we don't want to leave that toggle turned on, the automation waits 10 seconds and then turns it off again, ready to use next time. And just in case you don't like the GUI, here's the YAML configuration for that automation, so feel free to pause the video and have a good look if you need to. The final part of the puzzle is that Alexa routine. Provided you have both your shower and Home Assistant correctly talking to Alexa, then this should be very easy. In the Alexa app, go to the More tab and choose Routines. Now the Alexa app thinks that the shower toggle helper is a contact sensor, so when you add the event for the new routine, you choose a type of smart home, find your shower device, and select it to fire when it is open. For the action, again choose smart home, then scenes, and find the scene that corresponds to the shower preset you wish to run, and make sure the action is to turn it on. Save it, and you are ready to test. Yeah, I know there are lots of components in this process, but I have been running this for several weeks now, and it works every time for me. I am hoping that one day Mira will update the shower and enable an API, either local or cloud, but I've had the shower for years now and they've not shown any signs of doing that, sadly. Oh, and I nearly forgot, Apple HomeKit support. Okay, so you've got it working with Home Assistant, then you can connect Home Assistant to HomeKit using the guide in this video that I put together. Just share the button helper with HomeKit in your include entities list and it'll appear as a switch in HomeKit that you can turn on. Anyway, if you are interested in this shower or the Aqara door sensor that I used, then go and check out the links in the description. If you have a better way of doing this, then I'm all ears, so please let me know in the comments. Don't forget to give the video a like and subscribe to my channel for free to see more of me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.